Hello everyone, welcome to the 10th topic of this second unit of interference. This topic namely called as non-reflecting films. Generally, if you take convex lens, this lens has a two curved surfaces. We know these curved surfaces. Suppose a line passing through the center of the lens is called principal axis. In this, one light ray coming from the source on the principal axis is incident on first surface of the lens. Consider the intensity of this light ray is I. This is as shown in this animation. After the incidence, the light ray refract into the lens. But the refraction light ray has not 100% intensity. Certainly, some part of light ray reflected from the first surface of the lens. This reflected light ray intensity is IR. So, it is assumed to be IR. Consider surrounding medium for the lens is refractive index is mu 1. That means surrounding medium refractive index is mu 1. I am assuming that. And the refractive index of the lens medium is mu 2. But according to Fresnel's equations, we can evaluate the reflected intensity and transmitted intensity. So, the reflected intensity IR is equal to mu 1 minus mu 2 by mu 1 plus mu 2 whole square into I. Assume this is first equation. Similarly, the formula for the transmitted intensity IT is equal to 2 mu 1 divided by mu 1 plus mu 2 whole square into I. Assume this is second equation. For example, mu 1 is equal to 1 for air medium. That is, the surrounding medium is air and mu 2 is equal to 1.5 for glass. That is, lens medium is made with a glass. That means lens is made with a glass. Then put this in Fresnel's reflected intensity. So, it becomes IR is equal to 1 minus 1.5 by 1 plus 1.5 by whole square into I is equal to 1 by 25 into I. That means it is equal to 0.04 I. When we solve the above equation, it becomes IR by I is equal to 0.04. Hence, the reflected light ray emerged with 4% intensity. That means only 96% of intensity of refracted light ray comes in lens. Similarly, the light ray reflected in the second surface of the lens, this reflected light ray intensity has nearly 4%. As a result, the transmitted light ray comes from the lens and forms an image for an object. According to Fresnel's equation, the intensity of light ray on the transmitted light is nearly 92%. But normally in cell phone camera or if you take any portable camera, we have system of minimum 4 lenses. Hence, for 100% intensity of an object only, we get 50% of intensity, which is transmitted light come from other side of the object, from the lens. As a result, only 50% of intensity image is formed for the object. Hence, we need to darken the reflected light system for all lens surfaces. Then only we get 100% of intensity of transmitted light. Hence, basing on all these things, we discovered non-reflecting films. So, So this is the topic motivation for the non-reflecting films. For achieving this, consider refractive index mu 1, which is air medium in the space. Now again consider another refractive index mu 2, which is glass medium below the air medium. Now consider a thin transparent film having thickness T and refractive index mu, which is coated on the glass medium. This is shown in this animation. Now consider a light ray incident on surface of the thin transparent material. So what happens? The part of light ray is reflected, is as shown in this animation, and remaining part of light ray is transmitted into the transparent material and incidenting on the glass medium surface. At the surface of the glass, the light ray split into some part of light ray is reflected and emerges from the transparent material, which is shown in this animation. Hence, consider the emergent light rays, or assume that 1 and 2, which is shown in this animation. When these two light rays, 1 and 2, superpose on each other to get interfere, so the interference for these 1 and 2 light rays, when this becomes condition for dark, then the thin transparent film becomes non-reflecting material. Hence, the condition for darkness, delta is equal to 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2. Assume this is first equation. Here n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. Here mu is the refractive index of the thin transparent material, t is the thickness of thin transparent material, and lambda is the incident wavelength of light ray. For example, the light ray is incident almost normal on the surface of the thin transparent material. So for normal incidence, r becomes 0 degrees, that means cos r becomes 1. Hence, for first equation, we can write 2 mu t is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2. Why 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2? Because this is transmitted light system. Assume this equation is second equation. Here n becomes 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. For minimum thickness, put n is equal to 0 into second equation. So second equation implies 2 mu t is equal to lambda by 2. Assume this is third equation. From third equation, we can write t is equal to lambda by 4 mu. Assume this is fourth equation. Hence, if the thin transparent film has a thickness t is equal to lambda by 4 mu, then it will act as a non-reflecting film. So we will find out the refractive index for this thin transparent film. In order to find the refractive index of this thin transparent material, we will use the Fresnel's equation. So for complete destructive interference, we can write IR1 is equal to IR2. Assume this is fifth equation. Hence, the intensity of reflected light in air medium is equal to the intensity of reflected light in transparent material. According to Fresnel's equation, we can write as a mu 1 minus mu divided by mu 1 plus mu whole square into I is equal to mu minus mu 2 divided by mu plus mu 2 whole square into I. Assume this is 6th equation. Here in IR1 equation comes under refractive index I of mu 1 and mu. Similarly in IR2 equation comes under refractive index of mu and mu 2. That's why I written 6th equation in this fashion. Now cancel I term on both sides and cancel the square on both sides of 6th equation. Then we can write mu 1 minus mu by mu 1 plus mu is equal to mu minus mu 2 by mu plus mu 2. Assume this is 7th equation. Adding one number on both sides of this equation 7, hence we can write mu 1 minus mu by mu 1 plus mu plus 1 is equal to mu minus mu 2 by mu plus mu 2 plus 1. Assume this is 8th equation. Now solve this. So 2 mu 1 by mu 1 plus mu is equal to 2 mu by mu plus mu 2. Assume this is 9th equation. In the 9th equation, cancel 2 number on both sides and do cross multiplication. Then we can write mu 1 into mu plus mu 2 is equal to mu into mu 1 plus mu. Assume this is 10th equation. Simplify the 10th equation. We can write mu 1 into mu plus mu 1 into mu 2 is equal to mu into mu 1 plus mu square. Assume this is 11th equation. Now cancel mu 1 mu term on both sides. So we can directly write as a mu 1 mu 2 is equal to mu square. Assuming this is 12th equation. Hence we can write mu is equal to square root of mu 1 into mu 2. Assume this is 13th equation. That means the refractive index of thin transparent material is equal to the square root of the product of refractive index of air and glass medium, that is mu 1 and mu 2. Now if you take mu 1 is equal to 1 for air and mu 2 is equal to 1.5 for glass, then from 13th equation the refractive index of the transparent material is 1.38. That means the magnesium fluoride MgF2 has a refractive index which is exactly equal to 1.38. Hence, if you coat the glass material with magnesium fluoride with a thickness T is equal to lambda by 4 mu, then it will act as a non-reflecting film. Further, if you take a convex lens and then coated with magnesium fluoride material with relevant thickness, then this material acts as a non-reflecting film. As a result, we will get 100% transmission through this convex lens. So, this is a total description of this topic. So, this is our topic. So, please subscribe our Telugu Gamanam channel for more lecture videos. Click the bell icon for notifications. If you want to get lecture notes for this lecture video, click the description link below in the lecture video. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the next lecture video. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.